Everybody, Johnny Be Good here. Welcome to Toledo, Ohio. I am mighty, mighty pleased today.
In 1 mile, turn right on I-280 North.
One of you called me up yesterday and said that there is a feature on these phones called Dual Capture. And yesterday, I was frantically looking for it, and I said, "Nah, I can't find it." And I said, "Well, maybe because it's a different phone. Maybe not every phone out there is, you know, has that feature." Until about 1 minute ago, I found this little wingding feature. This is pretty neat. I love it. Uh-oh. I like it. I tell you what, this is pretty neat. I don't know how this is going to come out on YouTube or on a laptop later, but... And I don't know if I could change the inlet video where on the screen or not, but...
In 1/4 mile, turn right on I-280 North, and then keep to the left at 450 feet.
But for now, I am mighty, mighty pleased. Thank you, thank you, thank you. So anyway, welcome to Totally Due Ohio. Yeah, you heard me. Totally Due Ohio. Totally. The home of Maxwell Q. Klinger. Maxwell Q. Klinger lives around here. You know, for years and years and years.
Turn right on I-280 North, and then keep to the left at 450 feet.
For years and years, I've always dreamed of visiting Paco's restaurant. I thought, well, maybe one of these days in the summertime, I'll go ride my Goldwing from Sheboygan all the way here, get me some Hungarian hot dog.
Keep to the left on I-280.
At Paco's restaurant, and just go home. I think I can do it. Leave real early at the house.
Continue on this road for 3.6 miles.
Driving straight over here. Sit down for about 40 minutes, enjoy the hot dog, and then go home. You guys think that's excessive. I have learned that even pilots do these. They get on their Cessnas or their turboprops and they hop from one airport to the other. They just go airport hopping. I met a guy several years ago who bought himself a Thunderbird ultralight. He built it himself. It was a kit. He built it himself, assembled it. And from what I understand, he was going to, I gotta show you Toledo. I don't know if you're gonna be able to see that. But let's stick with the bridge. Anyway, he was gonna plan to put a pair of pontoons on that Thunderbird. And in the summertime, he was gonna go fishing.
In 1.5 miles, keep to the left on I-75 South.
That's no more ridiculous than somebody dragging a 20,000, 30,000 boat around just to go fishing across the state. At least with the plane, you just kind of landed right there by the lake, fish right there, go home later, right? I thought it was cute. Yesterday I was dumbfounded by the idea that
in 1.5 mile, keep to the left on I-75 South.
I was dumbfounded by the idea that there are two of you subscribers. One is a pilot and currently living in South Korea, and another subscriber is, let me see if I get that right, aircraft mechanic, I think, right? And the one in Korea said, hey, they're hiring over here. Started asking about turboprop license and qualifications. And I said, well, you know, dude, go for it, man. Go for it. Don't worry about the Korean language. Everybody in South Korea speaks pretty darn good English. Don't let the fear of the unknown. Don't let the fear of the unknown deter you. As I always said, it's better to fail, better to try and fail than to fail to try. Because you'll go through the rest of your life wondering what ifs. Then you'll be playing the game of what ifs in your mind for the rest of your life. I just thought that it was funny, that it was amazing that through another form of media, you guys can connect and possibly share, you know, jobs, experiences, informations, lives. I thought since today I'm not going to make it to my delivery point, and I don't need to deliver this until tomorrow afternoon. Well, basically I got 24 hours to deliver this load, and from here to there is probably, oh, what is it? 350 miles, maybe 400. I thought I'd take the back roads, do some nice footage and all that stuff. I got a confession to make. I'm an addict. Seriously, I'm addicted to... I'm addicted to something. I am ashamed to call myself a truck driver. I can't drive without my GPS on. Even to those places that I already know which way to go, where to go, how to go. Somehow I gotta have my GPS right. I feel naked running around without my GPS. I don't know how that came about. When I started trucking back in 1991, all we had was Rand McNally maps. And get this, from somebody like me who grew up in a Pacific island, in a very small island, in a village, with no electricity, imagine that little boy coming over here having to read a map real quick. So I learned it real quick too. I was pretty good at reading maps. Not as good as Brian Ray. See, Brian, pretty smart guy. He does all that latitude and longitude, and my brain was never designed that way. So anyway, when now that the GPS has come out, it is just so part of our lives now that we can't go across town without our GPS on for some reason. By the way, how do you spell GPS? I've actually had a few people fall into that. Their normal response was a global positioning position. I said, well, that's not what I asked. Somehow they can't get it in their brain. Like a sign I saw the other day. There's a question that said, how many wheels does a pair of roller skates have? I answered 4. Come on, how many wheels does a pair of roller skates have? Isn't that amazing that roller skates are almost gone? The roller blades. Alright, the answer is 8.4 wheels per foot. pursue. Hong Kong. Oh boy. All right, Blue, how far are we there, Blue? Let's ask Tom. Tom says we are 424 miles. 7 hours and 44 minutes left to drive. Problem is, Sandy only has 5 hours and 6 minutes left to drive. And if we don't get over soon enough, we're gonna end up in Michigan. Chicago traffic is always best. And it seems like Tom does not agree of my routing right now, which I don't really need his help. I know this road quite a bit. Now, having said that, you watch, I'll get lost. I'll get lost here in a minute. Just because I said that, that's just the way life works. I think Tom wanted me to go north towards 94 possibly. But I like this 20. I really do. Got a lot of character in it. And if you've seen a really pure white puppy on my previous intro video, not the picture, the intro. That's our first dog named Snowball. Snowball is an American Eskimo. Which I bought him along this route right here on 20. I tell you, he was the cutest dog you ever seen in your eyes. He was a purebred American Eskimo. Just white as white snow. Everybody in the house fell in love with him. Now, I'm not usually the emotional dog lover type, but when I had him, I tell you what, he made me so, he made me cry. He was just, oh man, he was a beautiful dog. Brought him home, everybody loved him. Unfortunately, none of my kids and my wife were ready for him. I guess purebred dogs are a little bit hard to handle. I paid quite a bit for him too. But I ended up giving him to one of my driver managers. Not Travis. Until to this day, my driver manager, Sherry, she still works for the company. And Snowball is now named Buddy. Is still with her. Boy, he's got to be at least 11 years old now. And it broke my heart too. I really wanted him. But just could not keep him at that time. Yeah, this camera needs to come down a little bit more. Now that I know this feature is existent, oh boy, I'm gonna have a lot of fun with this. Let me know how you guys think of this. Would you guys rather have just a clean video out there, or for now, I'm liking this right now. Well, look at the time. 23 minutes and counting. And it's now 1:20 p.m. That means I gotta call my wife. Remind her that it's time to go to work. Otherwise, she will fine me $20. Which I never pay. Kind of a game that she and I play. I have to remind her every 1:30. Otherwise, I will never hear the end of it. So, okay, I'll catch you guys later. Johnny B. Good here. Hi, everybody. Hi. Peace.